ordinary rice.
Yeah.
Never had as good pork as here. Pork was the best ever. In so many places.
It was nicely balanced.
A little bit spice, a little bit sweetness, very savory. Never had dry pork, it was so good.
Yeah. It's my favorite soy sauce.
Yeah, it's really
it's
nice.
A bit thicker.
Yeah,
it's
I
so sweet. 15 years ago in Germany, I didn't like it. Well, in Germany, but here I said, well, okay, now we have to try it. We're so good.
It's cultural.
Since then, almost every day we get bubble tea somewhere.
Milk tea is probably the best drink.
Yes.
A bit of water.
And much
and
milk tea.
Much milk tea because.
You're becoming Taiwanese, congratulations!
In Europe is Taiwan and Asia.
Yeah.
Good ingredients.
Yeah,
both.
Yeah.
Yes. Very, very good.
I think this kind of bread, that kind of bread, you can have everywhere.
Culinary wise,
yeah.
I would say we never had, or I never had, as good pork as here. The pork was the best ever. One place, and we would have said, oh, this pork is so nice here, that is the best. It was like 4 or 5 times that we said, oh, this is so much better than anywhere else we've been.
Yeah.
What the best part of the Taiwanese pork?
The spices.
The spices, yeah.
Like the flavors.
Yeah.
Are
seems
really
like
nicely balanced. Like you don't have one flavor a lot. You have like different flavors.
Yeah.
Made through a composition of flavors. This was really nice.
It felt like it was marinated all the time. That was one thing, and very well. With the flavors, very balanced, always a little bit spice, a little bit sweetness, very savory. And then it was cooked really well. So like still juicy all the time,
yeah,
not like dry,
yeah,
and
yeah.
It's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you cook pork, it gets too dry too fast. And we never had dry pork, it was so good.
Yeah.
Thanks for like we are just lifted from the international low bands to be able to export again. They are crazy about our breast pork rice now. They are crazy about Taiwanese food now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Even the hot dogs in Japanese chain stores, they
yeah.
have the Taiwanese breast pork rice flavor.
We never had hot dog here.
Hot dog?
Oh.
No, we didn't try hot dog.
You can try it in a convenience store.
Yeah.
A few days ago, I just learned that there are like thousands of different kinds of soy sauce. Taiwanese, Japanese, Korean.
Almost only in Taiwan, we are using the black soy to make the soy sauce. Sweet and tender soy sauce that you try.
Yeah, you can see it from the, it's like a little bit thick.
Yeah.
Favorite soy sauce.
Yeah, it's really
it's
nice.
A bit thicker.
Yeah,
it's
I.
So sweet.
You can see that I include that and. Soybean paste for you to make a beef soup noodle in Germany.
Yes.
The Japanese one, which is more
salty.
I think because they use more for the fermented wheat. Sorry.
We have sweeter ones.
Ah yes.
Yeah. But they also have the they call it extra sweet. But normal Japanese. Soy sauce is less sweeter than Taiwanese.
But then it was China who had less sweet soy sauce, no?
They have more salty.
Yeah.
Ah.
Ones. Yeah. And Indonesia is extra sweet.
Yeah. I think the ones you can get in the Netherlands and Germany are the ones from China then, right? Because they're always
usually
quite salty and not so sweet.
Yeah. That's why I don't like to use them that much.
Yes.
Yeah.
So next time we know that we pay attention where the soy sauce is coming from.
Get it from Hong Kong is also fine. Lee Kun King.
Remember that.
Okay, just remember to get some black soy sauce paste.
Real soy sauce. Okay. We learned anyway that everything with pork in Taiwan is really good. And it also counts for the pork floss.
Yeah.
Interesting flavor. And on the other hand, has an even more interesting texture because it's like a little bit dry, but if you eat it, it doesn't feel like
dry because you combine it with other elements.
Like Zucker Watte. You know these clouds of sugar? And when you eat it, it just dissolves in the mouth.
Yeah.
I find pork floss is a little bit like it.
Oh, the savory version of,
yeah.
Of the...
Asking myself what the right term is for Zucker Watte.
I don't know.
Let's call it Zucker Watte.
Zucker Watte, yes.
Yeah. Or cotton candy.
Cotton candy, yes!
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, cotton candy.
Yeah.
I got your back, yeah.
The rice balls were really nice.
No, baozi.
Kimchi, I guess.
And pork.
And pork. What was savory. That was really good. For
yeah.
Also for breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
Because they like this... this really nice consistency, but also the spice and the sourness of kimchi with the savory pork, and the combination was really, really good. Really nice.
Yeah.
And they're trying to combining all kind of flavors and spices and trying to find what can sell, what is good, what is...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I also feel like good at incorporating foods from other nations, like kimchi, for example.
Yeah.
Like this Korean.
That's also a thing I recognized here, that you have a regular combination of meat and seafood. It's not like it's very rare. You see it pretty often, but the combination is really nice.
Yeah.
So someone puts a steak and four shrimps, and it's like half surf and turf.
Yeah.
But here you get this combination more often, but it's really nice.
Yeah. We also have the braised pork rice with the oyster on top.
Yeah, a lot of oyster. Yeah, that's really nice.
You like the oyster, right?
Yeah, I like oysters. We had
oyster
omelette in Taipei.
Yeah.
It was so good. Also,
In Ningxia Night Market.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's famous.
It was so good because it was also very surprising texture-wise. Because it's very chewy. But it still has like this egg flavor combined with the oyster, and then you have this like sweet little bit sour sauce with it.
Yeah.
That's
right.
What I didn't finish for the oyster omelette.
Yeah.
That is the combination of the Western ketchup and and Japanese miso.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And Taiwanese bean soup.
It was really good.
That's also one thing. I think that surprised me a little bit. Pretty good here.
It's really good.
I was like, where does the best ice cream usually come from? Probably Italy, because they like invented it, I guess. Maybe not, who knows. But everywhere we ate ice cream, and it was from like from the 7-Eleven to a little like
gelateria,
yes. It was so good everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
It's about an island pushing the mix of every ingredients we have, and ice cream is about ingredients. Taiwan is, we have all kind of landscape, also means different kind of foodscape. So we have all kind of food available. So we are trying to, make
and
a motto.
What I noticed, because you put on the list of recommendations to try bubble tea.
Yeah.
And the last time I tried bubble tea, that was in school, like 15 years ago. In Germany, and I didn't like it. I didn't like the bubbles. They were not tasting well in Germany. But here, I said, well, okay, now we have to try it. We're already halfway through the holidays. Let's go and get some bubble tea.
It's kosher.
So good.
It's kosher.
Since then, almost every day, we get bubble tea somewhere. It's really nice.
What's the best part of the bubble tea that you tried here?
Yeah, it depended on which bubble tea we got. Sometimes it were the bubbles itself, which were just super amazing. Sometimes in other places they didn't have that much flavor inside the bubbles.
Yeah.
But then the tea with the milk, also milk tea was really good.
Oh, thank you.
The milk tea is probably the best drink.
Yes.
So usually at home we only drink water.
Tap water.
Yeah.
And
Wasser.
I think here we only drink
a bit of water.
And much
and
milk tea.
Much milk tea because
you're becoming Taiwanese. Congratulations!
Yeah.
But the milk tea was so good. We tried different ones, and we also this also really nice because probably because you're also producing a lot of tea here.
Yeah.
You have like different kinds of teas.
Yeah.
And therefore different kind of milk teas.
Yeah.
But you can really tell the difference.
Yeah.
Because it's so fresh and it's really nice.
Yeah.
Before it was just black tea for me.
Yeah.
Black tea. I don't like black tea. But here you have like 30-40 different black teas.
Glückwunsch for
and if you don't like
gradually
one,
becoming Taiwanese.
You might like the other
okay.
Yeah.
I think I want to
that's the,
a little bit more.
That's the German word that I remember from Happy Birthday.
Wobo Sho Shong Gwen.
Wo
Leit Si De Guo.
Okay, all these powders.
Wow. But you used it's a powder.
Yeah.
So you prepared like matcha?
You can
the same way with the
you can also just grind the tea leaves with the grinder.
This is a red oolong.
In Thai tone.
There's kind of strong.
Something between oolong and black tea.
This is more light than the red oolong.
But still, it smells really good. The teas are great here.
Yeah, teas are really
teas
great.
Teas and milk teas and bubble teas.
This is Sichuan.
And food.
Sichuan.
Four seasons. It means four seasons.
Oh, this is really good.
That smells a bit more green.
A bit more green and a bit more sweet.
Yeah.
It's really nice. I like this. Out of the three we had.
But there are three more to go.
Okay, the red one.
I just arranged them in the order I like the smell. This is number one. Ruby Black. I think we had Ruby Black. Isn't
that Samu Lake.
From Samu Lake, yes. Number
18
or...
Oh, yeah, professional.
Yeah. Yes. You can recognize this.
Directly.
Yes.
Because you are just back from the Salmon Lake.
Yes.
It smells a bit like berries.
Yeah,
you know?
Yes. Berries, a little bit peachy, maybe.
Yeah.
It's really good. This is really nice. And we also drank this, and this is... I like this a little bit more, even. Okay, this is
hibiscus.
Probably
this is flower.
Pretty more floral odor.
This is flower.
Yeah. It also.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is not really my kind.
Let's put it on the other end.
Yes.
This oriental beauty is from Hsinchu.
This is from Hsinchu. All right.
It has a natural milky scent.
Ah, nice.
Ah, that is cool.
I like that.
We also got the Sanun Lake tea, which smelled and tasted milky, although there's no milk inside.
You like it, or?
Yes, I really like this. I think that's really crazy because I never experienced something like this before because I don't have any idea how a tea can smell and taste milky without having milk.
Yeah,
in it.
It's this one.
It's really nice.
The Oriental Beauty name was given by the English Queen.
Ah.
And it gets even better when it's added with European liquor.
Okay.
Liquor.
Yes, just a little bit. Just find this Oriental Beauty, and I would recommend you the kind of liquor you should add with it and try it in Europe.
But as a cold drink?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
A cold, yeah.
Really nice.
Oh. That smells really good.
The funny thing is
yes.
that we didn't really had idea of how much of a tea producing country Taiwan is before we came here.
Yeah.
Because we're all like, yeah, we want to go to Taipei, we want to see the big city. We want to go to Taroko and go hiking and mountaineering. And we want to go to Kenting and want to do snorkeling and diving. And we were here, it was like, culinary wise, one of the, I would say, three best things we had here was the tea.
Yeah. Not only the pork, but
especially the pork. Yeah, the pork was outstanding.
In comparison to the European food.
Yeah, okay.
The pork is just average.
The
but
nature.
Here the pork was just very good. And
what
the nature.
Would you say?